Hey, all the gaming Bronc here with another episode of City Skylines. And what was once vanilla is now no longer. I have not yet installed the mods, but you can tell, I'll show you that I have added. Yeah, there. I've added some content, mostly assets at this point. Well, what the heck is this? I don't actually know what that is. It's a blank. It's a Dutch landmark for something. A couple of interesting... Apparently I have the exclusive coaster park. Nice. So yes, we've added a few monuments. A couple of nice little monuments that I think are interesting. I was looking kind of for the Space Needle. It's one of my favorite monuments. Or is that a landmark? I don't remember where that falls. That's not the Space Needle. That's the Sky Tower. Huh. Maybe I didn't get that one downloaded right. I'll have to go back and find that one. That is one of my favorite monuments, is the Space Tower, or the Space Needle, so we'll totally be working on getting that as well, because I was thinking of placing the Space Needle over here, maybe like somewhere around in this area. It'd be just really an interesting addition, I think, that landscape or that skyline right there. But if you haven't noticed, this is probably my favorite skyline in the city as right now. This one is a rivaling skyline, which I really enjoy. I like this skyline as well. Let's just take a moment. Drink in Hamster Dam for what it's worth. There it is. Hamster Dam. It's beautiful, really. I'm kind of a big fan. It makes me a little nervous with the water so close to the top of this dam, though. I'm like, well, a brisk wind and we could have New Orleans all over again. Thank God for no emergencies, because a Katrina-like event would destroy Hamster Dam, the city. The Statue of Industry would be drowned. But very, very interesting. I hope maybe in future patches they do create disasters, so we could experience a New Orleans-like tragedy in a place like Hamster Dam, and then try and clean it up and see if we can do a little bit better than the craziness that followed at New Orleans. But, you know, we have a pretty awesome little city going here. I buckled because we were having a traffic log down here in this part of the city. Like just a jam of unbelievable proportions in this part of the city because of ambulances. And the reason was I was trying to create some low income looking and style of housing down here. I wanted it to be kind of a, I don't know. I didn't want it to be upscale like this. I wanted it to look very downtrodden and kind of like living in the shadow of the dam kind of thing. And so I tried a trick that I used in SimCity all the time to create the low land value, and it didn't work. All it did was make all our citizens sick. And so I ended up building I had these two big hospitals down here. I had two clinics over here. I had, you know, another clinic over here. I had another, you know, I had all of our hospitals in the city full, and it wasn't working. It wasn't doing what I wanted it to do. So I did have to go through and rezone. And what I did is I took out most of the industrial areas around residential spaces. I left some of them, just because I did want it to have kind of that crusty character, industrial kind of I mean, we put the Statue of Industry down here, so I wanted to have some industry in it. I mean, it just didn't feel... I don't know. It didn't take on the feel that I thought it would. So, yeah, I rezoned. I rezoned it all, and we fixed it. I mean, for the most part, I don't have a glut of ambulances on the road. I still have some because, like I said, I left a bunch of industry in here. And there's still pollution on the ground in some areas that my residents are still trying to get over. So, it just didn't work out quite the way I thought it would or I wanted it to. So we just redid it so that it's pretty like the rest of our city for the most part. So yeah, there's that. And then up here, we're going to now dump in... I'm going to pause the game because we're going to dump in a bunch of industry up here and start soaking this oil up. Now, I wanted to show off something here quick in our imports, exports. We are importing a bulk of our oil at this time. And the reason for that, whoops, I pushed it away. The reason for that is these industries over here are all producing goods that take oil to make. Because this is an oil industry area yet. If I look at the district, yeah, you can still see the oil icon over it. So any industry I build over here is going to create oil manufactories. So factories that use oil to do their manufacturing, which I don't really want right now over here. I'm going to keep the oil factories over here, a few of them, but I am going to get rid of a bulk of them now. So we're going to be getting rid of these, getting rid of these. It's going to rezone commercial here. Get rid of these. I am going to keep a couple. I think I'm going to keep this line and then maybe a few along the coast just to keep some variation. So I think I'll keep that many there. And I think I'm going to keep those there. And then what I'm going to do is rezone... the bulk of this offices. Oh, that looks like a good spot for a little commercial place. We do that, 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 that. That, and then drop in some more commercial here. Just want to rezone that all. There we go. That way it's not, we're not quite so heavy. Yeah, it kind of took down a little bit on the oil importing. You see our exports. We're also exporting a good amount of oil, too. Forestry is actually doing quite well for us as well. I'm a little surprised that forestry is as high as it is, considering our only forestry area is this. And I made it look like a shanty lumber town, essentially. So I'm pretty excited that that looks as good as it does. Our tourism for low-wealth individuals has certainly upticked quite a bit. And obviously the statue industry is part of that. And then we have a good amount of commercial areas around the statue industry. Well, and even all the way up down the main road that people are coming in that are getting a good uptick from the tourism there. So that's nice. Clearly this is one of the prettier parts of our entire town, to be honest. I actually went back and redid the yellow flowers. I figured, cripes, if I did a thing of yellow flowers through blue and purple, I may as well go through the mixed ones, right? So I went back and did that. I still don't know exactly what that is, but it's interesting. I mean, I also have in my... I have a bunch of different trees. So in my trees here, I also have orange flowers that I completely forgot about that I could put down too. Maybe I'll do that in a different... Maybe we'll do that over here because we haven't got anything... It's fine the way it is. We're not going to mess with that park anymore. But I had another color that I could use. I don't know. It was really all an experiment, to be honest. I'm trying to figure out what I can do with those flowers. Those looked way better than I thought they would, to be honest. All right. God, we're having a fire over here. Oh, we got three trucks there already. So we're going to go ahead and start zoning in some of this industrial area. And of course, we're not going to zone on this. We're going to zone on this side. we have enough hospitals and clinics to take care of them probably. So we're going to go ahead and start our zoning right here, actually, where we know these guys actually have power and water. Let's double check on water. Yeah, I knew we were kind of close. Let's get this all zoned up so it's got water. You don't have to worry about it. Gonna be all good, all good. Because we are going to zone this all and get our industrial equilibrium back and see what kind of chaos this causes on this little inner... Oh, crap. See what kind of chaos this causes on this tiny little intersection. Well, it's not really tiny. It just... I don't think it's going to quite support the industrial traffic we're going to have here. But, I mean, I could very well be wrong. And that would be a very pleasant surprise to me. Okay, so our industries... Boy, our industry bottomed out really fast. Okay, let's see how big a building we're building here. Holy cow. Well, I mean, it can't be that big, right? We just built it. Oh, it leveled. It ranked up once already. Oh, it's a normal industrial building. Well, what's the deal here? Oh, he's not actually in the zone. Okay. All right. Well, buddy, I guess you're part of Hamster Dam, so that seems a little odd, but I guess he's part of Hamster Dam, so you know, do what you want. These other ones, though, should be coming in as oil factories. Yeah, oil factories. Okay, looking good, looking good. They're building. I built one elementary school down here, so we have a completely full elementary school down here. I did not over-educate Hamster Dam, hardly. Actually, I can honestly say I probably didn't do anything for education in Hamster Dam except for that one elementary school, which is working this half, kind of. High school-wise, there's almost zero access. So unless you're wealthy enough to go up to the upper high school, currently there's no access to a high school. I think we're going to change that, though. I think we're going to change that. I don't know where we're going to put one, though, is the other dilemma that I run into here. Maybe we could put a high school in here on the main road. I don't know. We'll stew on it. And I absolutely don't think there's any access to university there. Yeah, that's... I mean, the university grants access for quite a ways, but none that far away. Okay, so that's fine. We have lots of highly educated people in our burb here, so we're good. So, I think we're going to just keep zoning here. We'd like to get a good, healthy residential demand, and then we're going to go over to our city and do some more high-density zoning. I do have an area to buy, but I think I want to kind of develop this part up a little bit more before I start building, you know, I don't know. Like, I want to get this filled in near Applegate Corridor. We're going to redo this road a little bit. And find a connection, find a good way to connect. I'm thinking that we create some kind of T intersection here and bring this one over actually right where the existing road is, so we're gonna end up moving some stuff. But we gotta create some demand for it, so we gotta build some industry right now. I'm not a huge fan of building industry on that 4-lane road because that's already gonna be a mess to a certain degree. Well, We're going to try and not zone too close to early intersections like that one. Okay, let's turn the speed up and get her going. That should really take care of a bunch of industrial demand, I'm hoping. Yeah, see, we got our little pumps going already. I gotta say, look at how quick the oil resource is depleted here. It's just unreal. As soon as those little pumps come up, the oil source is gone. So there's really not much oil in the ground, even though it looks like there is. In the span of this video, once I zone this, the oil will be gone. And so next time we come back, we'll be rezoning this something else, because it doesn't make sense to have this huge oil factory area and nothing in it. So, because once these pumps get active and get hired, just watch it. Just watch the oil evaporate. Like, then these pumps will change into actually processing factories where they process the oil. So it just, it just kind of grinds your gears a little bit, because you're like, there was oil there just a second ago. Like, we built these here to pump the oil, and it's gone already. Oh, sigh. But, so we'll do the same thing we did over by Applegate Corridor. We'll pump all the oil out, and then we'll replace the oil rigs. Well, we won't completely replace them. We'll just limit them down to a little section where they process the oil. They no longer are pumping. See, these were once all rigs, and then they changed into these processing factories. Let's see how this is affecting our import exports. Oh yeah, they're turned back our oil imports. So that's cool. Our exports also turned back just a smidge. Goods went up dramatically with the additional oil. But yeah, it peeled back our imports of oil quite a ways, which is kind of cool. So we are pumping away. Let's double check on our natural resource. Yeah, see, we're already starting to get it pumped out over here as well. We're going to try and pump this whole section out. I'm going to try and pump this left side all out. And then I'm going to set up... Oh, they didn't get there in time? Oh, come on. There's a freaking giant fire department right there. They better get there in time. That is ridiculous. You're on the same street. Why is a factory worried about land value? That's kind of weird. Okay. If you're not happy, oh, too few services. Seriously? There's not... Yeah, there's great fire service here. What are you worried about that way? You got police service here. What are you worried about that way? Garbage service is just... Garbage is another thing that we'll put out here somewhere too, because we're just barely reaching these guys with our garbage trucks, and we do need another garbage station here if we're going to have a big area up and maybe over here connecting, you know. So I don't know how highly populated this area will be, but it will be an interesting area, but we can't build it without a small second edition of a garbage dump, which we'll put in. But for now, we just really want to get the oil pumped out, and I think I think we're efficiently doing that. So get that oil pumped out of there. More industry demand again, so these should pop up fairly quickly. I got some trucks that are going all the way around here. That's kind of interesting. Which is, that's great with, for me. I mean, I'm more than happy to diversify this traffic. I'm actually really happy that they're doing that. So I think I'm going to pump this whole area out right now. And then after this side gets pumped out, what we'll do is we'll dezone most of this industry, rezone it commercial offices, and try and keep our industrial workforce going. Hopefully this will give us some people, residential need for next time. Yeah, our residential need's already climbing. And then we'll go over and work on Applegate Corridor next time, and then come, and while we do that, this should hopefully all drain of oil. And then we'll come back to this the following and redistrict this again. I'm hoping that most of this will work fine. We're gonna kind of see. I know there's oil under all of those areas, so. We actually have oil all the way up to here. Let's go ahead. Why not? Let's just go ahead and dump some more industry in here just to make sure we got it all covered. There we go. That should more than take care of our industrial demand. So now our residential demand should shoot up. We have people moving into the city like crazy. We're making $3,000 a week or a day or whatever it is. Those guys should be using, like I said, we're gonna have garbage problems. So once we get, I'm thinking that we'll probably redo this area here once we get the oil pumped out. And we'll put our new garbage stations in there. See, yeah, these guys up here are going to have a serious problem with garbage at some point. So I think just to help them out for short-term purposes, I might just drop a... Yeah, what the heck? We're just going to... No. Wrong thing. Thought I had the incinerator selected. We're just going to drop a couple incinerators in up here. They will definitely move. They're not going to stay there. No way. But we're just going to drop a couple incinerators in there because I could actually move those without having to empty them. Basically what I do with my garbage, and this is kind of a slick tip, I guess, if you're curious about my garbage. The reason I never have a huge garbage problem. And actually, I could add more incinerators over here yet. Is I use my two garbage dumps as basically holding tanks for these industrial incinerators. Because if you notice, the garbage dump actually gets 15 garbage trucks. And the incinerators only... Oh, they get 27? What? That was different last time. I looked, I swear... Okay, well, now it doesn't even make sense to have garbage dumps. Before, I swear that that was different. Well, I guess there's no reason for me to actually have these garbage dumps anymore. I think those were tweaked somehow. Anyway, it used, I know that it was at one point... you'd get more garbage trucks for the landfill site than you did for the incinerator. So I was building these as holding tanks, and then once they were full, I'd just empty them into the incinerators. I'm going to leave them just because they look nice now, but there's no real reason to do that anymore, apparently. I mean, which is fine. I guess it's more realistic that way, because whether you're incinerating your trash or filling the land with it, you're going to have a number of garbage trucks. So, alright. It makes sense to me that landfills are near incineration plants, so those are going to stay there. I think I'm maybe at the end of the need, though, for incineration plants. I could fit another landfill in there perfectly right now if I wanted to. That'd be an interesting idea. Like I said, I don't probably need it. I don't know if I should do that. I don't think so. I think I'm going to put incinerators in because I've also, I don't know if you noticed, I've also been slowly high density growing this area. So just kind of eyeball that. We got some good high density buildings going up in here. This skyline's becoming a lot more interesting. I've got a, once I get the terraforming mod, we'll fix this hamster. It's his butt sliding down the crevasse there. So we'll have to fix him with the terraforming mod. But this skyline's getting a little bit more interesting. It was total Berbia, which it was beautiful. And it's still beautiful, to be honest. It still looks nice. Boy, some of these trees are towering over these little trees. But I guess that'll happen. I mean, there's nothing wrong with having a massive tree there either. A couple of them. Big evergreen, big deciduous. So that looks nice. I think it all looks nice. It's looking really good. We aren't actually getting overloaded with traffic here like I was afraid would happen. I think we have, since we have enough points of entrance, it's really, really helping us out. We do have the two interstate style connections. So it looks like I do have a few trucks running the 6-lane down and coming over that way. It does look like the bulk of them are taking this 4-lane right now because, well, currently we're building over here. So it's on the right side of the 4-lane. Which is not generating as much traffic here at this intersection as I thought it would, because we are siphoning it off at this intersection a little bit. We do have kind of a backup here, because this is such a short intersection, and that's stoplights there. So when the stoplights are on, yeah, that's kind of becoming a thing. I don't think that'll be a problem once we rezone this and get rid of the oil out of there, which has happened for the most part. Like I said, it goes really fast, so the oil is almost all gone already. So we're going to start removing some of these. Oh, I had a building burn down over here. Woohoo. Let's get rid of these. We don't need them anymore. There's no oil down here, so... And I think what we'll do here is we'll take and let Hamster Dam take over all these industries. So these industries are normal industries. Okay, something like that. There we go. So these industries should come back as just regular old industries. Let's check our oil resource here again. It's almost gone. So then you'll see here in our import-export, it adjusts. We're exporting a lot of oil products right now. So... we have a bit of oil left over there. And this oil will be just as quick. So, what do we got going on? We have a glut of not enough workers. Okay, well, that's going to go away here after a while when I continually dezone industries. We'll have workers that you don't know what to do with, buddy. There we go. All right, well, I think that does it for us. I think you get the idea of what we're going to go for here. We're going to slowly de-zone this to a point and then zone this one and suck all the oil out of that one just to get the oil out of the ground. I just hate having that resource down there and not being utilized, right? So, but we'll leave this one till next time, and I think that does it for this episode of City Skylines, so I hope you enjoyed. If you did, please like, comment, subscribe as you feel called. I really appreciate it. And until next time, comrades, game on.